Welcome to School Around the Corner, and today we're just around the corner from Campbell College in Belfast at Cabin Hill Prep. Now, I've always dreamt of being headmaster in a school like this.
I love Cabin Hill. I think it's magic.
It's a kind of magic. A kind of magic.
Young men of Cabin Hill, I am your new headmaster. Every morning at 11 o'clock, the teachers will serve you ice cream. Yeah! Never again will you have to do any homework. Yeah! Henceforth, every pupil here will finish lessons at 2 o'clock each day.
I am Inventor Ike, and this is Bob, my business partner. I am trying to sell him my everlasting gobstopper machine.
I see that our Jones is down 5 points.
Yes, I do believe they have performed quite badly this year.
I see your margins have landed on Earth.
Wonderful place with wonderful chaps. Now let's meet David Clark and Daniel McKay.
Daniel, what's the best holiday you've ever been on?
I don't know.
Where have you been on holiday, David?
Lanzarote.
Where's that? Is that near Bangor?
No.
Where is Lanzarote?
Well, it's near... I don't know.
Did you have to go in a plane?
Yes, for 4 hours.
Oh, that's quite a distance, isn't it?
Yeah.
And what did you do when you got to Lanzarote?
Well, I had to just pack up and go to a hotel called Los Feros.
Is that a posh one?
No.
Daniel, have you thought yet where you've ever been on holiday?
No.
Of all the places in the whole world, where might you like to go?
America.
Why would you like to go to America, Daniel?
Because we are going, and it's going to be, we are going to have a house, a swimming pool in the back garden.
Excellent. Is that in Florida?
No, America.
I see. Have you ever been to Bangor?
No.
You want to get down to Bangor before you go to Florida, because you'd be acclimatized for it down there, you could. Are you looking forward to growing up, David?
Yes.
What are you going to be when you grow up?
A pianist.
Are you?
Yeah.
And why do you want to be a pianist?
Because I played the piano.
It's a good thing to play if you're a pianist, isn't it? When did you start playing the piano?
I think about 2 years ago.
How good are you?
Not too bad.
You're very modest, David. What sort of videos do you like, Daniel?
James Bond.
Cool guy, Bond, isn't he? What sort of cars does Bond have?
Cool ones.
He certainly does. Are there many cool cars coming up the driveway into Cabin Hill in the mornings?
No.
What's the coolest car you've seen coming up?
Probably my dad.
Does your dad look a bit like James Bond?
No.
Is he cool, suave, sophisticated?
No.
Do either of the two of you like Harry Potter?
I don't.
I do.
Well, first of all, you tell me why you don't like him, David.
Because when you go to see the movie, it takes about 2.5 hours until it's over.
Did you find it a bit boring?
Yep.
Did you fall asleep during it?
Nearly.
Oh, dear. It's a good job you weren't on the review panel for Harry Potter. J.K. Rowling wouldn't have been too happy. Did you enjoy it, Daniel?
Yes.
Why did you enjoy it?
Because I like the spells.
Yeah, the spells are good. I think Cabin Hill's a bit like Hogwarts too, isn't it? Huh? It's a little bit like Hogwarts inside, isn't it?
No.
Yes.
David, certificate for you.
Thank you very much, Frank.
One for you, Daniel.
Thank you very much, Frank.
Two very polite boys. Sit there for another moment. Don't go away just yet. Who's coming next?
I can't remember what I'm going to say.
Is it Cowboy Joe that's coming next?
Yeah.
Cowboy Joe. Yes. We'll see what Cowboy Joe's up to over here.
Alexander, David and Rowan with Cowboy Joe. Now let's welcome Darius Kamen Fards.
Darius, I've always wanted to meet you. You are so good on Pop Idol. Well done, Darius, ladies and gentlemen. Did you think he was good on Pop Idol?
Yes.
Can you sing as well as him?
No.
It's a fabulous name, Darius. Where did you get the name from?
I don't know. My mom chose it from America, I think.
An American name. I actually first came across Darius, I think, in the Bible. Have you any brothers or sisters?
One tiny brother.
And what's he called?
Solomon. Solomon Cyrus.
Solomon Cyrus. And what's your full name?
Darius Payman Ford.
Do you have another name after Darius before Payman?
I don't know.
No,
David, I think.
David's in there. He's another king, too. Anyone related to you called Isaac?
Tennis.
How good of a tennis player is he?
He just teaches. He just hits the ball and I hit it back.
Is he a good shooter?
Yes.
Do you like sports, Darius?
Yes, very much.
What's your favourite sport? Apart from tennis, what do you like?
Swimming.
Do you play rugby or football?
Football on Mondays.
Would you be a big football fan?
No.
And what about rugby? Do you play rugby at all?
No, until I'm older enough, maybe about 9 or 10.
And why would you not play rugby now?
Because I don't want to get a busted knee.
I know, the old busted knee. That's the worst thing of all, isn't it? What would you like to be when you grow up?
A fighter pilot.
Oh, you couldn't be a fighter pilot with a busted knee. Have you ever seen any fighter pilots on TV or in movies?
A DVD I've got?
Oh, DVD. I have a DVD as well. Have you ever seen Top Gun on DVD?
I have it on DVD.
You do? What do you call the main actor in that?
Maverick, and his other one is a funny name, Goose.
Maverick and Goose from Top Gun. Well thought out indeed.
Have you ever been to London, Darius?
Hundreds and hundreds of times.
As you do.
And I know a funny story when I went to South America or America. A rhino, when I was 3 years old, a rhinoceros came after me.
A rhinoceros came after you on a visit to North America or South America. Which continent were you on at the time?
Africa, because I was only 3 years old.
Okay, so you've been to London hundreds of times, you've been to North America, you've been to South America, you've been chased by rhinoceros in Africa.
And I've been to Disneyland Paris, how many times? Five?
You've been to Disneyland Paris five times. Life must be so boring when you're a cabin <Yeah. laughs> All that and a big star on Pop Idol as well. Darius, you are a star. Darius, you deserve a certificate. Take that with your travels around the world.
Thank you.
Don't mention it, Darius. Coming next, Andrew Burns with Estuary on the clarinet. Fabulous playing, Andrew. Well done indeed. Now, join us for more fun here at Cavan Hill in just a moment. Yes, very welcome back. It's School Around the Corner at Cavan Hill. Let's welcome Jimmy Hunter and Patrick Calhoun.
Do either of you boys know anyone who does show jumping?
My mum does.
Is she a good show jumper?
Yeah.
What sort of horses does your mum have, Jamie?
She's got a ginger one and...
What does she call the ginger one?
Ginger.
And that's a good name for a ginger horse, Ginger.
And she's got another horse called Foxy and he's Ginger.
What happened when you tried the show jumping?
I just went into a show and my pony bucked me off.
Oh no, your pony bucked you off over the hurdles into the dirt. Was that sore?
Yes.
Do you remember it all?
Yes.
As long as the memory's there, that's the main thing. Now, Patrick, we've almost forgotten that you were sitting over there. Yes. Patrick, what would you like to be when you grow up?
I don't know.
You any idea what you might be?
No, I have.
What would you like to be, Jimmy?
A footballer.
And which team would you like to play for?
Man United.
Good team, aren't they?
Yeah.
But I think they're under a wee bit of pressure this year.
They're not. They're at the top of the table. You must remember that.
Well, just about.
Which of you boys have been to Australia? Were you on holiday or on business?
On holiday.
Did you go to Ayers Rock when you were in Australia, Patrick?
Yes.
What was that like?
Like a desert. And there was quite a lot of snakes. We were going to see the sunset, but it was really annoying because the clouds had, like, just taken over the sun.
It's nothing as annoying as going the whole way to Ayers Rock and the clouds blotting out the sun. Did you see any crocodiles
when
you were in
Rock.
Australia?
No.
No, probably not at Ayers Rock.
Know.
Sometimes I have.
You're losing your lines, aren't you?
I'm losing my lines badly. It's not easy being me, Patrick, but I... You have a joke.
Yeah.
I want to hear that joke in just a second, because I want to clear up this. I saw Crocodile Dundee. That's the only thing I know about Australia. And there were crocodiles in it.
Oh, I thought Crocodile Dundee was a movie.
Yes.
I think I'm a step behind here. I'm just 3 seconds behind.
You tell me your joke, Jimmy.
What do you call a sleeping bull?
I don't know. What do you call a sleeping bull?
A bulldozer.
A bulldozer. Very good. You tell me a joke, Patrick.
Why didn't the teddy bears not finish all the food at the teddy bears picnic?
Why did the teddy bears not finish all the food at the teddy bears picnic?
All the teddies were stuffed.
Good one.
You are cool boys. You both deserve certificates. One for you, Jamie. One for you, Patrick.
Thank you.
And who's coming next?
Cabin Hill Pre-Prep will now sing Piper, Piper and Rats.
Lots of peas in there. Here they are. Now, let's welcome Alexander Huston.
Are you a member of any clubs, Alexander?
Yes, the Young Ornithologists.
Young Ornithologists. Okay, do you need binoculars for that?
Sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Tell us what a young ornithologist does.
You go to places like Scrapple Tower and watch birds from a hide, maybe.
Mm-hmm. I'll spell hide. That's H-I-D-E, isn't it?
Yes.
Now, you spell ornithologist.
O-R-O... Oh, I have no idea.
It's O-R-N-I-T-H-O-L-O-G-I-S-T.
Very long.
I didn't know what it meant when I came in.
Did you not?
Well, I did, actually. Frank Mitchell, weatherman and birdwatcher.
Odd.
Very odd.
It's the first time I've ever been put down with just one word.
Odd. How true, how accurate.
Are you a boarder?
No.
Are you planning on being a boarder?
Maybe.
Why might you like to be a boarder in your school?
Because my friend boards.
What sort of things does your chum get up to boarding?
I have no idea.
There's a sort of a no-talk policy about what goes on. All the impish behaviour and the midnight feasts. I had a good look around. It seems like good crack it does. I heard there was a lion escaped from the zoo and you saw it.
Well, you see, there's these lions, and there used to be lions in a safari park over a bridge near where my granny lives. And once a fox, I think, dug a hole into the lion's pen and then ran out because it noticed the lion.
It would.
And then the lion got out
And then it was it had been prowling around Benvardin Estate, that's where my granny lives, for a while. And then it went straight past her garden gate where her dog was out. And it woofed and woofed and seemed to go mad. And then my granny went out and she called the police.
Thought you were going to say she caught the lion.
No.
So granny's on the phone ringing 999 and the lion's going down the middle of Ballymoney.
Yep. No, it was doing in the state.
In the Benvardin
estate. Then and the actual owner of the estate was out in Londonderry, so he didn't know. And then when he got back to the estate, the gate were closed because of the lion. And then the vets tried to dart it, but they couldn't, so the police had to shoot it.
What a sad story. I thought you were going to say they caught it.
No.
They ran their fingers through its mane. They put it back in through the foxhole and back into the enclosure. Oh, what sort of a fright did your granny get?
Quite a fright.
What about the fox?
No one knows what happened to it.
You're a great storyteller. Alexandra, the nature storyteller from Cabin Hill.
Alexander, thank you very much. Final certificate on the programme. And who will be our final performers today?
The Cabin Hill Junior Choir will sing Sailing Away.
They will.
Time to take a vacation. Get away from it all. Think I'll go to Jamaica.
Thank you for joining us here at Cabin Hill in Belfast. Don't forget, next time around, we could be at the school around the corner from you. Bye-bye.